What is going on, guys? Grave here. Today we got information about the Season 1 Battle Pass from Treyarch. They kind of give us a lot of details about what we can expect with the Battle Pass. Before I get into it, if you're not a subscriber, make sure you hit the subscribe button. If you are a subscriber, make sure you have notifications turned on. Smash the like button if you do enjoy the content, and be sure to check out everything down in the description, the community Discord, my Twitter, and of course the affiliate here on the channel, GT Racing. They still have their Christmas sale going on, so you can use that affiliate link down in the description if you'd like to, you know, purchase something from the website. Anyway, guys, things we got today with this kind of info from Treyarch was kind of talking about what we can expect. They didn't give every single detail about all the stuff within the Battle Pass, but they did state that when the season launches, it will be 1,000 COD points to purchase it, or $10 here in the U.S. They will also offer 1,300 COD points aside from the other things that you can get, blueprints, skins, that kind of thing, in the pass. So if you complete the pass, you will get 1,300 COD points back. Also, they talked about where and when you can get some of these items throughout the pass itself. When you get when you first purchase the pass, of course, if you have, you know, the free version, or if you have, you know, the purchase version, you still get some items with the free version. But when you purchase the pass itself, you will get the instant access to the Stitch new operator, some skins for Adler and a mission, Silver Flash watch, and the seasonal XP boost, which is 10% XP boost to all XP during the season. Just for playing, like I said, you're going to get 1,300 COD points total. New free base weapons. Now, these will be available to everyone, whether you have purchased the pass or you have the free version. At tier 15, you will get the MAC-10 SMG. And tier 31, you will get the Graza Assault Rifle. We have new weapon blueprints as well. We get a blueprint at tier 81, tier 85, and tier 95. The one at tier 81 is a free blueprint to everyone. The one at tier 85 and tier 95 will be blueprints if you have purchased the Battle Pass itself. Of course, you get some more operator skins as well. You get an operator skin at 10, an operator skin at 90, which is free to everyone, and a pain in the neck finishing move at tier 19. Some other things you will get once you complete the Battle Pass, once you reach level 100, is the Stitch skin and operator mission for Stitch itself. It's called Prisoner, Natural Order, which is the assault rifle blueprint, the assault vehicle skins, and the Season 1 emblem. Also, they talked about if you want to purchase the, you know, the Battle Pass bundle, pretty much the same concept as Modern Warfare. It will cost you 2,400 CP. So 2,400 COD points, that will give you instant access to everything, plus 20 tier skips. So you'll be able to get or unlock the MAC-10 right off the bat if you do buy that 2,400 COD point Battle Pass. So same as Modern Warfare, you know, you can purchase just the normal pass, start out at zero, or you can purchase that kind of pass that gives you a little bit of an extra boost, and it will put you to level 20, which is pretty nice. They did not mention how long it's going to take to rank this up. They didn't say anything about, you know, XP time or anything of that nature. I'm assuming probably, you know, maybe hopefully a little bit quicker than Modern Warfare. Modern Warfare's was a bit slow in my opinion. I'm not sure, of course, how long it's going to last. They did not mention that either. They didn't say if, you know, if it was going to be 30 days, you know, 40 days, 50 days. If it kind of follows suit with Modern Warfare, it will probably be a little quicker to begin with, and then the later we get into seasons, the longer it will take, you know, to go from season to season. That's kind of how Modern Warfare worked. The first couple seasons were a lot faster than the last couple seasons. It seemed like the last couple seasons were 50 and 60 days, where the first few were anywhere between like 35 and 40 days. Anyway, guys, leave me a comment with your thoughts if you're excited about Season 1. Of course, you're excited about this Battle Pass info. I was glad to see that they left kind of the price for the Battle Pass at the same area or same kind of place it was with Modern Warfare, that 1,000 for just buying the normal Battle Pass, and you're able to make 1,300 COD points back in the Battle Pass itself is a pretty nice addition. Of course, guys, if you like the video, hit the like, and I'll catch you all next time.